I was actually back in 1996. The federal government had just passed welfare reform. I was with Arkansas Advocates for Children and Families at the time, and I had done a lot of research on the law, and after that law was passed at the federal level, groups in the state were looking for us as to what they should do. I'm including cities and counties and even the state legislature. And so I was kind of thrust into a leadership role along with another colleague of mine. And so we helped form a coalition that really helped develop the state's response to that. I think in terms of challenges right now, both the political and economic environment are very challenging. If you're a leader, especially if you're running a nonprofit organization, you have a lot more things to contend with than I think you did 10 years ago, and especially for an advocacy organization like us. The political landscape has changed in such a way that our work is just much, much tougher today. One, we were very instrumental back in 1997 in the creation of the Our Kids First program, which is the healthcare program for uninsured kids. And as a result, the uninsured rate for kids has been cut from nearly 1 in 4 kids down to less than 6%. That's a huge accomplishment for a poor state like Arkansas. It had a major role in getting access to quality preschool expanded for low-income kids. And research is really clear that pre-K can have a huge impact on the ability of especially low-income and vulnerable kids to succeed in school, graduate from high school, and go on to college. I would like to think that if we weren't around, that I don't know that children would be always considered in a lot of the important decisions being made, and I don't think some of the policy issues that I know that are important to children and families would be in the minds of decision makers the way that they are today.